Welcome to Office 2013, video number 9. Hey, we're going to start off by downloading a start file. We're going to download this. The link to get to this web page is right below the video. I'm going to click, and we're going to send this to our class notes, Highline, whatever quarter we're in, Business 216 class notes, and we're in Word for class notes. The file name, Video Project 9 Research Paper, no format start file is perfect, and so is the save as type. I'm going to click save. I'm going to go over to Windows Explorer. Do the same thing. Just like the save as dialog box, I'm digging down. Did it go to the right place? Did I save it? Yes, it did. Now, what we're going to do, this is a video about a research paper. We're going to learn some cool tricks for research papers. But this one has all the text, but no formatting. So we're going to open this and then open up a second blank document. So you ready? I'm going to open this up. Close the clipboard. This is our no format start file. I'm going to Ctrl N. All right, and so document one is the name. I'm going to hit F12 to save as, and I'm going to dig down to that same folder, Fall 216 Class Notes. And in Word, I'm going to give this the name, some smart name, like I'm going to call it something like Finish Research Paper Video Project. Where do you want to save it? What do you want to call it? And the file extension, I'm going to click Save. All right, so we're going to learn about documentation style and for a research paper. Now, in the textbook, they talk about two different styles, APA, American Psychological Association, and MLA, Modern Language Association. The notes handout that I have has like a bulleted list of all the style elements. Now, the first thing is we're going to go over to the Reference tab. We're going to go over to the Citations and Bibliography, and right away, before we do anything, I'm going to select the documentation style. We want MLA 7th. That way, when we create our Works Cited, it will know to do things like hanging indent for our reference material. All right, so what's cool about Word is you pick your style, and it will, to some degree, understand what this how this research paper should be formatted. Now, a bunch of things that are required in this style. The very first thing is margins. We've got to have margins all the way around. We know it's page layout. We could use this dialog box. We could use the drop down there. We know the keyboard, Alt, PSP. And I'm just immediately going to go, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, all the way around. That fits this style. Escape. The next thing is, and I'm going to go over to Home, is we're going to use New Times Roman or Times New Roman and font size 12. We could change that here, but watch this. This normal style, we talked about this last video, you can actually modify it, and then for this document, whatever formatting you add will always be applied. I'm going to right click, Modify. Now there's a few things we could do here. Under character level format, I'm going to say Times New Roman, 12. We can also, in any style we're modifying, come down to this button right here. We have all sorts of options, and I want to get to some paragraph level formatting. I want to get rid of that by saying double, and I want to get rid of this 0. So we're going to do some other paragraph level formatting later on for the bulk of our text, but for everything, the text, the Works Cited, they will all get this double spacing, 12 font size, and Times New Roman. Click OK. All right, so before we write our paper here, we want to add a header. That means on each page, there's going to be your name and a page number. Now, there's a couple ways to insert a header. We could go up to Insert, Header, and then we want to go down to Edit. That will open it. I'm going to click Close. Or watch this. See the margin at the top? I can just come up here and double click. Now look at my cursor there. It has a little alignment. That means right align. Whoa, center align, left align. That means I can actually click and double click. And it will immediately, just from my insertion point and double clicking, and this works anywhere in your document, it will automatically align. Now I'm going to Control Z. Another way to do that, obviously, is to come up to Home and click Right Align, or we could use Control R. Now you type your name. Now where I wrote your last name, I want you to just write your last name. Then type a space, and we need a page number. I'm going to go right up to the Header and Footer Tools Design ribbon, and over here, Page Number. I'm going to say Current Position, and just select this first one. Now, the cool thing about this is that that's a special number one. If I close this footer and watch, I'm going to, just to show you, Control Enter. Oh, look, I jumped to the next page, Control Enter. That is so cool. Now, that's not part of the body of the text. That is a special grayed out thing. You can't edit it until you get back into edit the header mode. But notice, it's automatic. It will increment the page number as we carry forward. Now, I'm going to Control Z, Control Z. I got rid of those two. Control Enter, which were page breaks. Now, one other thing, if I wanted to edit this, I can double click it. And I want to show you, how do you know that that is a special type of text which automatically does something, like when we hit Enter, it automatically increments? Well, you can look and see the code behind the scene with Alt F9. Alt F9, look at that. Page slash and then merge format. So Alt F9 is a toggle. And this is the first time we've seen this. And we will see this a few other times in the class. It's just when you Alt F9, it shows you behind the scene the secret code that does what it does. All right, don't get stuck in this mode. It's a toggle, so Alt F9. I'm going to close the header footer. Now, we're ready to start typing. In MLA, you don't have a title page. You just have a line to the left, double space, your name and other information. I'm going to jump over to my other Word document using Alt Tab, and I'm going to highlight name, Professor, English Class, Control C, Alt Tab, Control V. Now, luckily, the formatting from over in that document was the same here. It had double space. If it wasn't, you would say paste text only. And actually, we will encounter a situation in just a moment where we need to use that smart tag. Now I'm going to hit Enter, and we're required to put the date. Insert, date and time, and there's a bunch of options. The first one is the one that's going to be required for this style here. If I click OK, it will just hard code the date. If I were to check this like I was building a template, that means every update automatically means every time I open this Word document, the date would change to today's date. Now I'm going to uncheck that. I do not want to automatically update. I want this hard-coded. I'm going to click OK. All right, so no title page. We've done our header. We've done our information at the top. Now I need to center this and add a title. Home, paragraph, Center, or Control E. And the name of this research paper is Antivirus Programs. Now Enter. Now we're ready to type our text. I need to align this to the left. Actually, I need to do a bunch of paragraph formatting. I'm going to do a right click and paragraph. So, not centered, we need it left. Indentation, we want special. This documentation style requires a 0.5 tab at the beginning of each paragraph. We don't want to have to type those, so we just say special first line indentation, and it will automatically happen. All right, we got our double space. I'm going to click OK. All right, Alt Tab. I don't want to type this research paper here, but I do want to highlight everything. I'm going to click that first line and scroll down. And before I click on the end, I'm going to hold Shift. Now I'm going to Control C and Alt Tab. Alt Tab jumps between those two windows, and Control V. And just like that, oh, look at that. It did not take the formatting I had here. No problem. This is an exact case where we want to point to our smart tag and say, paste text only. And just like that, our first line indent worked perfectly. Next, we want to add a footnote. So we want to come to the second paragraph and the very end of the first sentence. I'm very carefully going to click after the period, but before that space. Notice that space is a non-printing character, and it's helping us position the footnote here very carefully. Now, footnotes in the MLA style are used for explanatory notes that go beyond what is written in the text. So, with our cursor there, we're going to go up to References, Insert Footnote, and watch this. Instantly, it puts a superscript number 1 there, a 1 down at the bottom, and a line. Now, this footnote has a style, and we need to change it to match the style of this document here. So we want to right-click, and notice it says Style. Now, if I right-click up here in the text, there's no style on the context-sensitive ribbon, and the reason why is there's no style there. Here, this style is automatically applied when you insert a footnote. So right-click, context-sensitive menu. I click on Style. It already is showing that I have footnote I want to modify. 12, New Times Roman. Come down here to the Format. Click Paragraph. And I'm going to select Double for line spacing. Click OK. Click OK. Click Apply. Wow, that was 3 dialog boxes deep. Alt-Tab to go over to our Word document. And very carefully, I'm going to highlight this without the paragraph mark. Notice our non-printing characters are very helpful when we're constructing Word documents. Control-C to copy. Alt-Tab to jump back over to my research paper. And Control-V just to make sure. I'm nervous here. I'm going to point to that paste text only. It doesn't look like it changed at all. All right. Now, that's a footnote that explains a little bit more than we wanted to write in our text up here. Another interesting thing about footnotes, of course, if I were to, do something silly like that, of course, it moves. So Control-Z. By the way, Control-Z got rid of all of those enters. All right, so footnote. Now we want to do a citation. We want to give credit to the person where we got this idea. So this is the second paragraph at the very end. Now, watch this. Right after the computer and before the period, I'm going to type a space. Now, we're going to go up to References, Insert Citation, and here's what's so cool about this Reference tab and this Insert Citation and Add New Source. We're going to have to write some information. We got this from Karanos, this idea on page 201 to 205. But we're going to enter the data for this reference right into New Source. And because we enter it once and only once into this dialog box, we'll be able to use it in citations. And when we click the button to create our Works Cited, our bibliography, it'll automatically be created. All right, so I'm going to click New Source. All right, now one cool thing about this is if you select from this drop-down, the fields change, and they're trying to help you to figure out what you have to put in this reference here or this source. All right, so this is a book, so I'm going to write the author's name. Tab. The title is Internet Security. Tab, the year, 2013. The city. And I'm going to click OK over here. By the way, if you click this, you can just decide from what you want. It shows you all the possible fields. I'm going to click OK. Now, this is a citation right here. in parentheses, we want to edit it. So I'm going to click in it, and on this right-hand side gray bar with the drop-down, I'm going to say Edit Citation. And I'm going to add some page numbers. You can suppress and put different information. We'll do that in our next one. This is from 201 to 205. And click OK. All right, so that is exactly in accordance with our MLA style. We have a parenthetical reference. This will show up later in our Works Cited. All right, our next citation, we're going to come down to the third paragraph here. And it says, according to Shelley and Cashman. And right after Cashman, we're going to, and before that comma, I'm going to type a space, insert citation. Oh, look, that's already available in this list. So if you're using the same citation or reference over and over, boom, you can get it from there. I'm going to say add new source. I'm going to click the drop down, document from the web. February and 15th. All right, I'm going to click OK. Now this one, we just mentioned the author name, so I'm going to click inside of it and click this little drop down and say Edit Citation. Suppress the author. Click OK. Just like that, it gets the name of the web page. Now, we need to come down to a footnote here because we're going to have this is someone else's idea also, and we need to give credit. So at the end of horses, I type a space before that period, insert new source. All right, this is going to be an article in a periodical, the author. Are going to be 51 to 55 to 61. I'm going to click OK. What's so cool is we enter it once here. We can use it for our citations and our works cited at the end. All right, so this one also, we had our name just up there. So I'm going to click in our citation. Click on that gray drop bar to the right. Edit citation. 55 to 61, we're going to suppress the author. And I want to check title also because I only want the page number. So I'm going to click OK. All right, now we're ready. We have our three citations. We're going to come to the end, Control N, wherever that is, and our Works Cited for our bibliographies at the very end on a new page. So Control Enter. There's our non-printing character. I better change the paragraph settings here. Right click, paragraph, and I want to get rid of this first line indent. Click OK. I'm going to type Works Cited. Actually, you know, I don't need to do that. There's a few ways we could do this. Now I'm going to go up to Bibliography, and you've got to be kidding me. Look at this right here. Click, and instantly it gives us our Works Cited, including our hanging indent. All right, Control Home. There's our research paper. We did a header up here. We did some paragraph level formatting. We did a footnote right there. We did a number of citations, and then because we entered it all into the dialog box, there was an automatic feature that just popped out our Works Cited. All right, that's it for this video. We'll see you next video.